Church is an organism. It's a living organism, just like we talk amoeba and cells, and those is a living organism because it is a composition of believers who were dead in their sins, but Jesus gave them life and they were brought into his body. So it's a living organism. And so because it's living, it has systems. There's life system, just the way your body has blood circulatory system, lymphatic system, nervous system, all those things. This is why the church has departments, and they must be alive. Those departments must be alive. Amen. If it is the economic and department. Economic, it must be alive. Do you know that God is going to raise men and women and make them millionaires in this church so that they can support the works of this ministry? Because that is a calling also. Hallelujah. As he is going to call preachers to preach the gospel, he is going to empower some of you. Yani hiwe kwako dollar power, haujui ukumbuke account iko na pesa ngapi. Maana hata hiyo ni neema ya Mungu. But if he can trust you, when he gives you that level, you are not going to be stingy, you are not going to be arrogant and proud and walk around with a kyphosis of your backbone and bragging and that kind of a thing. God can give you anything as long as he knows and he is sure that you are going to give back to him. Hallelujah. The church is an organism. In other words, we are saying there is life in the church. Number two, the church is the called out people that have been called from the world of darkness, from the world of Satan, from the world of sin, and they have come to Jesus, and their lives have been changed by a new birth, and they have a new life. Is that group of called out people, group of born again men and women who come together to worship the Lord. Hallelujah. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. The called out ones from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of light. And kwa Wagriki, maybe to sound a little bit learned religiously, you can put that in Greek, wanaita ecclesia, the called out ones. Maybe I can spell for you. You can write E-K-K and then L-E-S-I-R, ecclesia. So as long as you get what you're saying. Ecclesia, the called out ones. Those that heard the call and they came. Jesus called his disciples. He called them. They heard his voice. They came. And his intention was that they may be with him. They may fellowship with him. They may learn of him. So that after they have learned and qualified, he will send them and give them authority to preach the gospel, casting out devils. Hallelujah. And if you look at Mark, it begins by, they shall cast out devils. Why cast out devils? Because some of the addictions, some of the allergies, some of the sickness and diseases that are tormenting people, a great fraction, three quarters, they are backed by demonic spirit. And this is why Jesus will rebuke spirits out of people. Now and upon their conditions are healed. Hallelujah. The church is the body of Christ. The born again men and women, they form the body of Christ. If this building was built with bricks, the church leaders, the pastors, they are supposed to be builders. Though the Bible tells that Jesus is building his church, then church leaders could be the watu wa mikono. Hata kama titles zao ni gani. Maana Yesu ndiye anasema lete hiyo matufari hiyo, anaangalia anasema hii kata hii kona ndio ifiti kwa ile kona. So it is the work of the pastors to fix you where you belong in the building. It's the work of the pastors through teaching to do your placement, placing you in the right place whereby you are going to enjoy serving the Lord without stress. Hallelujah. It's a body of Christ, born again believers. And its membership, the membership of the church begins with two members to three, two to three. Yes, akasema, in St. Matthew 18, yeah, akasema, if two of you shall agree on anything that you pray, it will be done. That is called prayer of agreement. And then anasema, where two or three are gathered in my name, I am right in their midst. So that is the lowest number for a church that wants to grow. That where two or three gather in his name, his presence is assured. Praise the name of the Lord. If you look at Acts of the Apostles, chapter 20. Mtu moja nisome mstari wa 28. Acts 20, verse 28. If you get it, please read for me. We are saying here, we are saying number three, the church belongs to God. I have a young brother of mine who is a teacher retiring at the end of this month. He's a pastor of our local church at home. And so this is why the rebuilders, leaders, need to think about where they came from. Kule mulitoka, kuna watu walisaidia nyinyi kusoma Sunday school. Na kufundisha nyinyi kumemorize verses. Hata kama wakuwa wanashika network vizuri, nyinyi kwa neema ya Mungu mmeshika network. So you need to begin to think about when are we going this year or next year or the other year. When are we going to take a crusade? Hata kama sio pale village kwenu. Maana nabii hana heshima kwao. Hata hapa makutano tunaweza weka kitu hapa. We just need crusade ya siku ngapi? Tatu. Ama ine. Tuanze Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Ikiwe metangazwa posters, mewekwa vizuri. Tuende huku tulipuke. Na tuwe tumeidentify hall fulani, mahali fulani. Na tunawambia hii Sunday inakuja. Sisi tutabudu hapo. Na sisi zote tuende huko. Tuache Simon akishika dini hapa. Akiubiri hapa. You know, here we have enough personnel. In fact, here we are overstaffed. By the grace of God. By the grace of God. And you are enjoying several graces. You are blessed, church. Sasa nyinyi muna enjoy grace, varied graces. Because all of us operate from different graces. Tumepewa neema tofauti tofauti. And niwaambia wakati nilikuwa nawaonyesha hii kidole, the fivefold ministries, niwaambia only teachers have the grace to penetrate. Kuchimba na kuweka neno la Mungu, precept of a precept, into your hearts, into your spirit. Nisomewe hiyo Acts 20:28. Kupata soma tu. Kitaka tupea loudspeaker, tunaweza kupea.
Take care and be on guard for yourselves and the whole flock over which the Holy Spirit has appointed you bishops and guardians to shepherd the church. That is, tend and feed and guide the church of the Lord God, which he obtained for himself, buying it and saving it for himself with his own blood.
Asante. So according to that reading, the church belongs to God. He bought it with his own blood. Nikuwa nasema kule nyumbani kuna ndugu yangu, my young brother who is a pastor, na kisimama huwa na wasalimia. Ikanisa yanga hii mwaseo. Ikanisa yanga hii. And that excites me inside. Ya kwamba anaelewa sio yake. Ni kanisa yanga hii. Church of God. Asema kanisa la Mungu mko salama. Mumekaribishwa. Kanisa la Mungu. Yani, he is planting the seed in the minds of the people. This thing is not mine. It can continue when I'm not there. Maana kuna makanisa mengine wachungaji na mabishops wanaenda haraka sana, maana wanaanza kubehave kama yule aliitwa Herode ama nani yule alipigiwa makofi. Wasema ameongea kama Mungu. Huyo ni Mungu mwingine. Saa hiyo he was struck by lightning yangai, and the worms began eating him right away. So pia kanisa la Mungu ina taratibu zake na nidhamu zake. Hallelujah, the church belongs to God. That is what I'm saying. And in Matthew 16, verse 16 to 19, tunaona Yesu mwenyewe akisungumza juu ya he will build his church on the foundation of the sum total of the conversion or the fact that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God. Maana niwauliza watu mkizunguka huku wanasema mimi ni nani? Wasema wengine wanasema ni Jeremiah, wengine wanasema John the Baptist, wengine wanasema hivi na hivi, kulingana na vile walimuona. Watu walisema. Maana watu watasema. Alafu akarudisha sasa mpira kwao. Na nyinyi mnasema mimi ni nani? Simon Peter akajikusanya. Maana alikuanga mstari wa mbele. Kanisa ni ya Mungu. And Jesus declared, even as the writer of Acts of the Apostles writing, yani kanisa ni ya Mungu. And it is built on the foundation that can never be shaken, that cannot be, in fact, I think it's also Paul who is saying there is no other foundation that any man can lay. The church is built on the foundation. I listened to a sermon from Peter Youngren. He's a tycoon. I think he's not a trillionaire, he's a billionaire. And there were some times he was coming for crusades here in Nairobi. Yeye mwenyewe ana fund his crusades, ana beba watu na mabasi kumalikualete Uhuru Park for a crusade. He's a rich man. So you begin to wonder, huyu mtu tajiri namna hii, na ananyenyekea, ana upako wa Mungu kuhubiri injili ya Yesu Kristo, ishara na miujiza zinalipuka. And then I listened to someone where he was saying his topic was bye-bye Moses, bye-bye Elijah, it's all about Jesus. Bye-bye Moses, bye-bye Elijah, it is all about Jesus from now on. Bye-bye. I said, you know, now I don't say, kwaheri sheria ya Musa and all the systems, kwaheri the Old Testament, the prophets. Now Jesus has come and things have changed because he came to fulfill the Old Testament. Alafu akakwote ile mstari Hebrews chapter 8 verse 7. Akasema, if the old covenant did not have problems, did not have malfunctions, there was no need to kuitupilia mbali na kuleta ingine inaitwa New Testament. I mean New Covenant. Na nikashika network vile alikuwa anasema. Maana pia mimi ni msomi wa Bible. The only foundation that was laid and that cannot be changed, that was laid and cannot, and I want to give you that first. Mtu mmoja tusome 1 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 11. Tunapotafuta, nafikiri siku malisha ile statement nilikuwa nasema kwamba there are some preachers, so even some apostles who have gone prematurely, who have gone to be with the Lord early and prematurely because they began to receive some glory. There's this professor, Canadian professor in Park, who used to tell us, used to give us three big G's. And God said, man, don't touch the glory. Don't touch the gold. Don't touch the gold. So the way we handle money in the church, the way we handle ladies and women, or women in the church, and I'm going to tell you, don't touch God's glory. It's for him. Unaweza tumiwa malaika wa slaughter usiangai na usikia kwamba kichwa yako imeenda. Kucheza ni mbaya. Kanisani hakuhitaji mchezo. Hakuhitaji mang'aa. Tunatakiwa tufanye kazi hapa tunyenyekee. Hallelujah. Bible inasema the year that King Uzziah died. The year that King Uzziah died. Heavens were opened. Na Isaiah ambaye alikuwa na cast state house. Nafikiria alikuwa cast new relative wa huyu mfalme. Ameingia huko, ameingia mshenea huko, ameingia, amekula ugali ya ikulu, amekula pesa dollar power ya ikulu, maono yakapotea. Biblia inasema when the king Uzziah died. Sijui tulikuwa tunaona ndege ya sijui country plan ambayo ilipotea ikaenda kugonga milima, and the president of that country and is it the prime minister or minister of finance and the others, they perished. So to us, this was a new, it was not a breaking news, because we have lost a whole general in our country with a kind of crash. So when King Uzziah dies, mbingu sikafunguka, touch kubwa ya Mungu ikamlika huyu nabii wa Mungu. Mungu anamhurumia asipotelee hapa ikulu. Akamlikwa pua, na picha yake ikachukuliwa ikawekwa kwa screen na tochi angai. Akaona mdomo yake mkuu mrefu cha, akalia, "Woi, nimekwisha. Nani ataniokoa?" Sasa alipolia hivyo, Mungu akatuma malaika akaenda to the altar. Akachukua alkala moto. With the tongues. Akakuja kwa a whole prophet. Akafanywa vile kuku sinafanyangwa kule kwetu Ukambani, sinapoanza kutoa na kiingana ngunia za mahindi. And then after that cleansing, kambiwa makosa yako umesamewa, dhambi zako zimeisha. Sasa ndio anasikia sauti nyingine nasema, nani ataenda kwa ajili yetu? Nani ataenda? Akasema, "Bwana, niko tayari nitume." Sasa unashindwa. Chapter 1 kuna mahali anahubiri ujumbe mkali wa kisheria. Anasema, "Come unto me those," anasema, "Njoni kwangu hata dhambi zenu kama ni nyekundu sana zitakuwa nyeupe kama theluji." Nani alikuwa amemtuma huko? Na saa hii anaitana asema nitume. Sasa anata ama ni second touch, ama ni recovery and restoration. Hallelujah. Next time we will discuss some of the methods that we can use in this church as our strategy to grow the church of God. Maana ni mapenzi ya Mungu kanisa likue. One of the things that we may do before the year ends ni ile kwa makanisa mengine wanaita service ama Sunday ya friends and neighbors. When I went for the revival meetings in Tasia, that Sunday I was preaching and they had a service walikuwa naita friends and neighbors. And in such a service, people are allowed to bring all their friends, all their neighbors to the church. Na walikuwa wamepika pilau, na mishikaki, vitu kama hizo. Ilikuwa na kachumbari silikuwa. Because they believe when we give our tithes and offerings, the Bible says, "So that in my house there may be food." So when sometimes we treat ourselves and eat, we are right in the scriptures. We are right under the anointing. Hallelujah. Nataka niombee mtu ambaye anasema, "Pastor, niombee, mimi niko na stress. Mambo yangu imeenda kinamna nyingine." Wewe inua mkono juu kama unahitaji maombi, nataka nikuombee kabla niende kukaa chini. Unahitaji maombi? Kuna mambo fulani unaona haiendelei vizuri, unataka Mungu akusaidie katika maeneo fulani ya maisha yako? Inua tu mkono, nataka nikuombee kabla niende kukaa chini. Weka mkono juu namna hii. Inua mkono. Unahitaji maombi. Inua vizuri. Sinue kama unaongopa. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this first service. And we thank you for your word. We are praying the grace for church growth that you have initiated by your own will and pleasure. May this grace continue to be multiplied Sunday after Sunday. May we come rejoicing as we celebrate, as you bring men and women into your church. We want to thank you for helping us to know and to discover today. A church is not a building. It's the born-again believers who come to worship together. We want to thank you and we want to pray that as men and women flock into this sanctuary, you will help us to lift up Jesus so that they may see Jesus and their lives are changed and they are blessed in the name of the Lord. We thank you. Touch those men and women who lifted up their hands that they needed your help. May you meet them at the very point of your need, of their needs. In Jesus' mighty name we pray and we believe. Sema amen. Upige Yesu makofi.